Mace production. I can't hear y'all clapping.
question is, what are we willing to embrace, and what are we willing to do to either cause God to come and bless us or bring judgment upon the nation? Now, if you've been watching your news here lately, the threats have come with Vladimir Putin and Russia and America, and now they have annexed this small little space south of Ukraine to be a part of its regime. The threats of imposing sanctions were supposed to prohibit the Russian president from going through with his action, and it failed. In fact, the president of Russia appears to be ignoring everything that America is doing right now. At one time, those threats would stop him in his tracks, but what's happening now is that there is a increase of ally activity in the Russian territory. Now, all of this is important because what you have now is a rebuilding of Russia. Right. And in fact, he's saying you can cut your sanctions off, or you can impose your sanctions to do anything you want to do. The fact of the matter is we're getting strong enough where we can get our aid and assistance from other nations and don't have to bother with y'all at all. So when you find this happening, you find the prophecy of Ezekiel 38 about to come to pass. Now you're hearing in the past few days that China is linked with Russia. Now this is important because what's happening now is that there's a development of the armies, Russia, Iran, and Syria. These nations here, ladies and gentlemen, now are really putting together an ally, and to the point where America's threat won't mean anything anymore. Now, Israel is now in preparation and want to know, well, what's the next move, because ultimately, all nations are going to turn against Israel because Israel seek to keep the laws of God. Even America is breaking away from the commandments of God, and we are currently in an identity crisis. We are so sloppy now, even not just economically. We are also sloppy with politics. We are now sloppy with raising debt ceilings and things like that. We are also now sloppy with religion. Religion. And it is so to the point where many people don't know what to believe anymore. You'll find people defecting from good churches, and it's called apostasy. And this is what the Bible spoke about when he said there will be a great falling away. Now, Pentecostal churches said falling away from the church. That ain't what the Bible said. The Bible didn't say falling away from the church. These folks ain't falling away from the church. They're just relocating. Somebody got that. They're not falling away from the church. We have what you call rotation of members. They get mad with this church, they go join another church in the same community. They get mad over there in a few years, they go join another church. It's a rotation of members. The population is 7 billion people strong. We are only 10% of the population in religion. 90% is still lost and on the street, which brings to pass the prophecy of Jesus that the harvest is ripe. Yes, but the laborers are few. So while we in church clamoring, fighting for position, rolling our eyes at each other, can't stand to be, you know, you're hot today and you're cold by night. She was your best. One world religion. One world government. One world economic system. They're going to move from paper trails to the numerical system. And someone say, well, what has all that got to do with me? Well, I tell you what, there are a lot of folks that have no idea what is about to take place. The signs are already in the heavens. Some of you may ask the question, what signs are you talking about? The only thing I know is snows, it snows. We're not talking about snow, and we're not talking about rain, and we're not talking about weather pattern. We're talking about something greater than that. We're talking about something that the wise men saw clean over in Arabia and spent several months getting to Bethlehem. And the explanation was, we have come to worship the King because we have seen his star. God has been talking to us from the heavens ever since the beginning of times, and we keep missing the signs. We keep missing the signs. If you're taking notes, you may want to put down Matthew 16. He talks about how you are hypocrites because you can tell the weather right down to the hour. Oh, the rain will stop around 6 p.m. Sun is going to come out the next day. We got that packed. He says you can discern the pattern of the weather, but you don't know the signs of the times. Lord, help me in here. And if you don't know the signs of the time, you won't know what sign to look for when it comes down to the return of Jesus Christ. And the signs are already up in place now. NASA just came out with a report. And some of you may have already heard about the book that just came out, Four Blood Moons. If you haven't heard of it, you will real soon. The four blood moons, which a lot of us don't know a thing about, actually testifies and prophesies about events that are about to take place on the earth. If you don't know that, then how in God's name are you going to know what to pray for? We are missing the signs. The next, and NASA report says the very first blood moon is going to take place next month. Did anybody know that? Next month. It's right there on you. The next blood moon is going to take place in October of this year. The next blood moon is going to take place April of next year. March of next year. The last time the heavens lined up like that, ladies and gentlemen, was 2,000 years ago. In fact, there's only 8 events of you having a sequence of those blood moons lining up as close as they are with a few months differentiation of 2 years of four blood moons and a solar eclipse within 2 years is telling you that something devastating is getting ready to take place on the earth. Those blood moons is to suggest to the nation of Israel, be prepared for attacks. How is it that four blood moons line up for that? And if those that are in Israel can see that and they'll understand that, they will know that trouble is on the way. Yes, but not only that, but there's a solar eclipse of the sun, according to NASA's report, by March of next year. That means all of the other nations, including America, need to get ready for something serious and something devastating that's about to take place on its shores. And some of you have been hearing something about peace treaties. You've been hearing about how they're trying to give away some more land in Israel. Every time America gets involved with the peace treaties between Israel and the Palestinians, God follows the representative back to America and something major happens to us in storm. Every time it happens. Every time it happens, it would suggest that God gave the land to Israel. Anyone found tampering with that and affecting that land by giving up territory to those that God did not give the land to, God gets upset in heaven and take it back out on the nation that was responsible, or the one that was key to literally being in the negotiations of giving up that land. Yes, so when you turn on your news and you hear that John Kerry or someone else is over there negotiating for that land, you better get ready for something major to happen to this one. Every time that happens, and we have on record 57 times that after we were instrumental in the Palestinians taking some of that land, something happened to America. And ladies and gentlemen, it's getting ready to happen again. When you have those solar systems setting up like that, God is speaking from the heavens to say, warning, not only to Israel, but warning to America and warning to everyone who is a part of the Gentile nations, I'm getting ready to strike again. Now, the only thing that you need to really praise God for is that God has made you a child of His. And when God makes you a child of His, then He will begin to respond like He did, ladies and gentlemen, during the crisis in Egypt, where Israel was not affected by the judgments of God because they lived in a place called Goshen. And while they were there, the hail hit Egypt, but it didn't hit in the Goshen. The frogs went to hopping in Egypt, but they didn't hop in the sinks in Goshen. The lice came into Egypt, but they didn't come to Goshen. And I'm here to tell you that when God gets ready to bring about His judgment, only those who are tuned into Him will escape this judgment. But if you are a part of the world system, you better get ready for the battle of your life. How is it that you're sitting in church? Can't hardly pay attention with all of that trouble you got going on in your life. How is it? How is it that you can come to church and look around, see what everybody got on? What color or how high the shoes was? My God. What color the earrings was? The whole nine yards. How can you hear God when you have literally found out what folks wear, what they're doing, what they said, what gesture they made in church? No wonder you couldn't hear God. Talking about sitting in church. Everybody, football players coming out talking about I'm gay. Basketball players, y'all ain't saying nothing up in here. And prouder, and every time somebody make an announcement, somebody else get the courage to make one. And they jump up and down. Here come a beautiful girl coming down the runway talking about she's gay. I said, great day in the morning. Is anybody got any sense left in this chat? Anybody got any sense left in the world? Aren't you glad? Aren't you glad He gave us enough so we can live off of? I don't know about you, but I'm trying to get tuned up. He's coming back again. I want to be ready. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, I want to be ready. Oh, when Jesus come, Lord, I want to be ready. Lord, I want to be ready. Lord, I want to be ready. Put your arms around somebody and tell them like Jesus went, He's coming back again. He's coming back again. I used to love to hear Polly. Polly used to sing that song.
starts when we were sold. One of the lies taught us every day. When we went to school, black history had no place. What are the lies? How long must this last? I'll tell you the truth.
If you'd like to know more about your heritage, please stop by the Cosby Educational Heritage Center in the Ocey Hill Neighborhood Center at 445 Bowman Street. For appointments, please call us at 419-775-8834 or 419-571-4627. And always remember, education is the key.